Government has concluded the process of gazetting the Traffic and Road Safety Regulations 2022 and under statutory instruments 49, the registration of the new number plates with enhanced and stronger security identification features will commence effective 1st July this year. The country is estimated to be having close to 2.4 million vehicles, 1.4 million motorcycles, and each of these has to get registered afresh for new digital number plate. Anyone purchasing a new vehicle or motorcycle will have to pay 713,000 for digital number plate, while those replacing the old number plates will have to pay 150,000 shillings for the vehicles and 50,000 shillings for motorcycles. The move has, however, eked the traders and transporters, accusing the government for abnormal costs of the number plate amidst the high cost of living. The argument is that these costs are too high compared to neighboring Kenya, which charges only 80,000 shillings for vehicles and 40,000 shillings for motorcycles, yet these number plates bear the same security features.
Have they raised this cost to 730,400 shillings? Again, we have not had any satisfactory answers as to why the exorbitant cost has been put there. But we hope and pray that through sensitizations like this and through bringing the correct party, maybe the people in charge will come and explain to us why this cost has been hiked up to where it has been put.
Also needs to explain why me, who is buying a new border, I have to pay more than 700,000 shillings, and someone who already has a border on the street and just is getting a number plate is paying 50,000 shillings. That is already more than 600,000 in just the difference, which is unfair, for which no explanation has been given.
They've recommended that this initiative should first be introduced as a pilot plan of about 5 years, coupled with a lot of sensitization, and it should be implemented in a phased manner, beginning with government vehicles.
We feel that there has not been adequate sensitization, and we have, through our engagements, asked the ministry that, yes, as much as you want to implement the 1st July deadline, please take a seat back. Get to the masses, get to the people, go down to the border.
Text that exists in the document that the ministry has prepared, and we are telling them, do not rush. We are telling them, take time and study and engage these people who are industry players.
They have also warned the government against rushing into initiatives, thus asking for one extra year before implementation takes place. Report by Jaliet Namoya for the news.